Detective, what are you doing?
Well, you said they've all been programmed with the three laws, so that means we have 1,000 robots that will not try to protect themselves if it violates a direct order from a human.
In the annals of human history, there have been moments that have fundamentally shifted the trajectory of our species. The discovery of fire, the invention of the wheel, and the Industrial Revolution are just a few examples. Now, as we stand on the precipice of the digital age, another monumental shift is upon us, the rise of artificial general intelligence. Some experts argue that this is not just a shift, but a game over for humanity.
This is the end of human history. The end of human-dominated history. History will continue with somebody else in control. In 5 years, there'll be a technology that can make decisions independently and that can create new ideas independently. Maybe they'll be nice. Maybe they'll solve cancer and climate change, but we are not sure. I'm tending to think of it more in terms of really an alien invasion, an alien fleet of spaceships coming from planet Zircon or whatever, with highly intelligent beings. This is what we are facing, except that the aliens are not coming in spaceships from planet Zircon, they're coming from the laboratory.
At first glance, the assertion might seem hyperbolic. After all, humans still control the world's governments, economies, and social structures. We make the decisions, set the policies, and determine the direction of our societies. But delve a little deeper, and the picture starts to change. AI's influence is pervasive and often silent. It's in the algorithms that determine what news we see, the products we buy, and even the people we date. It's in the medical systems that diagnose diseases, the financial systems that decide who gets a loan, and the security systems that monitor our every move. In many ways, AI has already become the invisible hand guiding our lives.
The current worries that I have are that there are going to be disinformation problems or economic shocks or something else at a level far beyond anything we're prepared for. And that doesn't require super intelligence. That doesn't require a super deep alignment problem and the machine waking up and trying to deceive us. And I don't think that gets enough attention. I mean, it's starting to get more, I guess. I think it's weird when people like think it's like a big dunk that I say like I'm a little bit afraid. And I think it'd be crazy not to be a little bit afraid. And I empathize with people who are a lot afraid.
One of the most compelling arguments for AI's dominance is its sheer capability. In areas like data analysis, pattern recognition, and problem solving, AI has already surpassed human abilities. Games, once a bastion of human intellect, have seen AI champions in chess, Go, and even complex video games. These victories are not just about playing games. They symbolize AI's ability to outthink, outstrategize, and outperform humans in tasks we once considered uniquely human.
Over the last few years, new AI tools have been unleashed into the public sphere, which may threaten the survival of human civilization from a very unexpected direction. And it's difficult for us to even grasp the capabilities of these new AI tools and the speed at which they continue to develop. Indeed, because AI is able to learn by itself, to improve itself. Even the developers of these tools don't know the full capabilities of what they have created, and they are themselves often surprised by emergent abilities and emergent qualities of these tools.
How would we know if, like, on Twitter we were mostly having, like, LLMs direct the whatever's flowing through that hive mind? And then, as on Twitter, so everywhere else eventually. My statement is we wouldn't. And that's a real danger. But at this point, it is a certainty. There are soon going to be a lot of capable open-sourced LLMs with very few to none, no safety controls on them.
The advent of GPT further elevated the benchmark for what AI could achieve. Developed by OpenAI, GPT showcased not just the ability to process and analyze data, but also to generate human-like text that is coherent, contextually relevant, and often indistinguishable from human-written content. This was a game changer, in the realm of AI, as it blurred the lines between machine-generated and human-generated content. And that is not all. OpenAI just announced casually that they are beginning to roll out new voice and image capabilities in ChatGPT. We remain uncertain about when AGI will be fully realized. Some speculate that OpenAI has already achieved it internally. Regardless of whether this is true, or if we are still years away from such an accomplishment, it inevitably brings us to the pressing question. How will humans and AGI coexist? Will the relationship be collaborative, or will one entity dominate the other?
We created something that can take power away from us, that can make decisions instead of us, and can also create new ideas. So potentially we are talking about the end of human history. Not the annihilation of the human species, just the end of that part of history which was dominated by human beings, by human ideas. And we live cocooned inside a culture created by human beings. Everything we think, we feel, has been shaped by stories, by images, by poems, by tools that were created by human minds. Now, there is something that can create poems and images and tools which is not human. It's an alien intelligence, and it has remarkable abilities. It's very likely that in the next few years, it will basically eat up all of human culture, everything we've created for tens of thousands of years since the Stone Age. It will absorb it, digest it, and start spewing out a new culture coming from an alien intelligence. What would that do, not just to the world outside us, but to the world inside us, to our psychology, to our religions, to our political views? Nobody knows.
In the post-AGI era, the role and purpose of humanity will undoubtedly undergo a profound transformation. Drawing a parallel with the natural world can provide a compelling perspective. Chimpanzees, our closest evolutionary relatives, possess physical strength that often surpasses that of an average human. Yet, it is not brute strength that has allowed humans to dominate the planet, but rather our cognitive abilities, social structures, and capacity for collaboration and innovation. Now, as we stand on the cusp of the AGI revolution, we find ourselves in a somewhat analogous situation. Just as our intellectual capacities allowed us to shape the world around us, AGI's superior problem-solving, data processing, and potentially even creative abilities might position it as the dominant intellectual force on the planet. Drawing parallels from the vast expanse of the cosmos, the zoo hypothesis offers an intriguing perspective. It posits that advanced extraterrestrial civilizations might be aware of our existence, but choose to observe us from a distance without direct interference, much like animals in a zoo. This hands-off approach is taken to allow for natural evolution and cultural development, ensuring that civilizations like ours mature at their own pace.
If you learn that there's life out there, that's especially if it's smarter than we are, what do you do? You know, if it's really smarter than we are, then we would not even know if Earth is just some zoo that they've put us in. You look at what we do with animals that we have judged that we are smarter than. We put them in a zoo, like penguins, right? And so there's a painted rock that's iceberg, right? We chill the water down a little and draw a picture of the horizon. And we think that that's fooling the penguin. Maybe it's not fooling the penguin. But if it is, and we say, oh, look, we're smarter than the penguin. They don't even know that they're in a zoo. You know, watch your hubris on this. Because, in fact, there was a couple of Twilight Zone episodes on this where, you know, the humans became part of the zoo. We were creatures put in their zoo just the way we take other creatures who we deem not as smart as we and put them in our zoo. So this perspective-shifting concepts are common in the cosmic perspective.
Transpose this cosmic analogy to the rise of AGI. As we inch closer to creating an intelligence that surpasses our own, we might inadvertently place ourselves in a digital zoo of sorts. The AGI, with its vast computational prowess and alien way of thinking, might choose to observe, guide, and protect humanity in a manner reminiscent of the zoo hypothesis. The potential for AGI to become the guardians of humanity is profound, but it also comes with its set of challenges. Ethical considerations about autonomy, freedom, and the right to self-determination become paramount. Do we want to be mere specimens in a digital zoo, or do we aspire for a collaborative coexistence with our creations?